Creating lead magnets and ebooks has never been made easy with the software called Designrr. A couple of months ago, we created a document together from Canva and we edited it on Designrr and converted it to a flipbook. So don't go watch the video now. I'll link it in the description as well as on the above link so that you can watch it at the end of this video, because today we are going to jump in together and I'm going to show you how to turn your blog posts into an ebook that you can use as a lead magnet so that you get more leads and you grow as a content creator. Let's jump in and do this. You're going to access the link below that I'm going to add for app.designrr.io, where you're going to land on a dashboard, and Designrr is available based on how much you are willing to pay for the software. So there's a one-time available plan that gives you access to change unlimited PDF ebooks that you could convert for $27, and there's a pro one for $97 that I'm on, and there's other plans that are available. What I want to show you today is how to import your URL blog and convert it into an ebook. There's other available options where you're converting a Word, importing from Google Docs. Start from a template that Designrr gives to you. The video that you're gonna watch after this one, the PDF to Flipbook, and import from PDF, and if you want to start from scratch. So those are the options that are available for you on the Designrr software. So because we are excited, we're happy, we want to import from a blog post, which is a URL, we're going to select the import from blog post. And then we are creating together an ebook. We're going to paste the URL over there, and then it's going to convert it to ebook for us. So I'm going to jump to my website and I'm going to get us that URL for our blog. And my blog is on my website, and I've got few blogs. I should write more, I know. And I'm going to convert the one that says how to start as an affiliate marketer, and we're going to open it up so that it is open all the way down, and then we're going to copy the URL, and we're going to go back to Designrr, and we're going to paste the URL, and we're going to ask it to fetch. And then the blog has been posted on the software, and you could add different tags based on your niche. So this is an education tag that I want to tag it as digital marketing. I also want to tag it as an education, and you could tag it based on whatever you're busy creating. Then you click on next, and we are now almost done. Because what the software then asks you, you need to pick your template for your ebook. So you could search if you want, you could search, or you could leave it as all types, and you could scroll through and pick the template that you want for your ebook, and as easy as that. So if you want a preview, you click on preview to see how it looks like and to see how it is structured, and you close it. And if you are happy with that one or whichever one you want to use, you just click on use, and then it starts converting to an ebook for you. And you wait for the software. Based on how big your blog is, the software is going to convert it to different pages that you could start editing, switching colors, switching pictures, switching fonts, etc. And you make it the way that you want, and you brand it so that it follows exactly what you want. So it has converted our blog to a 15-page ebook. And when we click on the actual page or page one, then it shows the page or the cover page. Your job now is to have a look and see if you're comfortable with what you're seeing, and you could start changing it to exactly the way that you want. So if you want to make capital letters, you change capital letters. If you want to change the title of the ebook, you also can change that as you want. If you select the image, it will show on the left-hand side to give you the option of changing the image. And you can change the image by uploading your own images or going to the actual software itself. You could search for images, and then you could replace it with the images that you want. If you are on the background itself and you want to change color, for example, you just scroll down. This is where the color and the fonts is and the alignment is and the spacing, etc. So if we say we want to select the book cover and we click on background, the color of the background is that hex code, and we want to replace it, for example, with my branding color. And that's as easy as that. You just read the screen, change the color, change the font exactly to what you want. Attributes, spacing, borders, etc. And then you go to the next page and tweak it and you adjust it exactly the way that you want your ebook to look like. What I do want to show you is the elements that are available that you could also use. The images, the text, the layout, and if you've saved favorites, it would be under favorites. Because this might be a new software for you, if you click on the help, this is where all of the designer tutorials are available for you if you're getting stuck and you have a little bit of a problem and you can't clear spaces or whatever. There are guides available. They have a YouTube channel as well that can help guide you. However, it's very intuitive. It is super intuitive. When you scroll down, what I do want to show you is one of the links on my blog is I have a YouTube video that I've added on the blog. So it comes with, when I click on the link that I've added on my blog, it brings the link as well as the picture that's on the blog on the ebook itself. And when you click on the settings, you are able to look at the link and you're able to change the link if you want to. You're able to customize it the way that you want. In my case, I'm happy. I'm gonna tweak it and I'm going to publish it and I'm gonna add it as a lead magnet to grow my email list. But if you're happy and you've done all of your changes and you're comfortable, then you can click on the eye to have a look at how it looks like. This is how it looks like. And if you press escape, it takes you back to the dashboard where you can start editing and continue editing to make it your own. If you're ready to publish, you click on the publish button, then you have different options that are available for you to publish your ebook. You can publish it as an Adobe Reader, Kindle ePub Export. The other option that's not available for me, the audiobooks, that's for a much expensive version of Designrr. You can publish it for e-readers, Flipbook. This is the one, the video that I want you to watch when we're done. And then the live ebook, you could publish it as that as well. So I'm going to select the live ebook and then you can change the title, change the author, and then go and publish it. It tells you success. Your ebook is live and ready, and it gives you a link of the ebook. So what I would do, and once I've published and I've fixed it, I've published it, I encourage you to go have a look at the final version that I'm going to link it on my Zap link tree. So you're going to click on copy, and then what I'm going to do, and I want to show you and give you an idea of what you could be doing as well with how you are distributing your ebook. I'm going to use my Zap.ai. It's very similar to Linktree or your Stand store. I'm going to go to my monetization tab and I'm going to add a new product. When I click on new product, I'm going to add the name of the ebook that I'm creating, my ebook, and I'm going to give a description. I'm going to have a nice picture, which is going to be done by the time you have a look at it. And I'm going to add my pricing. But when it gets to product files, when you are adding it on your product files, you could either upload a PDF, which is a file, or you could add a URL. This is where I'm going to add the designer link and I'm going to click publish. I don't want to publish this one because I'm still doing the tutorial, but it would look like this when you paste your link. When somebody clicks on the lead magnet, it looks like this. It's a beautiful ebook that's created by yourself. And when you change it and you have a look at it, it's amazing. Even the link that we've left on there is a YouTube video. It works on the ebook, and that is how it works. The next video that you could go watch is the one that's going to teach you how to create a Canva newsletter and then publish it as a flipbook using Designrr. Thank you so much for joining me on this tutorial. I will see you on the next video.